Hey YouTube, it's the Apple iPhone Helper, and in this video I'm going to show you how to create your own icons for your iPod Touch or iPhone using GIMP. So what you need to do is go to your computer and just open up GIMP. If you don't have GIMP on your computer, there'll be a link in the video description over to your right over there to download that. So just download that and install it, then open it. Now that you've done that, you'll get something that looks like this. You'll get like a toolbar over here on crap. So what you need to do is just click on File and New right there. So click on that. File, New, and you'll get this. The width has to be 60 and the height has to be 60. Just like that. So it's that easy. So just do that and click on OK. You'll get this. If you want, you can click on Tools and Zoom. So you can, you know, just click on the picture and zoom in. Or if you want to zoom out, you can just go over here and you can zoom out. So you can just click on that to make sure it has a dot on it. And then you can zoom out. I'm just going to put it there because I like that. It's easy to see. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to change the color to it. So I'm just going to click on this like little fading box over here. So just click on that and you'll get this sort of thing pop up around here. You just have to, the mode here has to be different. So click on mode and go down to look for difference. So it'll be like that. So now when you've done that, you can click on these two squares here. And you'll get this. You can choose the color that you want. I like it about there, sort of bluish, lightish color. And then click on OK. Now what you can do is just go to your picture and just draw lines. So just drag and draw lines. I like that. It's like this sort of cloudy color thing. So anyway, I like that. So now to add a text on top of the icon, go up the top here to layer and click on new layer. Alright, and then just click on OK. Now you can just go over here and click on the A. Alright, and now you can drag on the icon and you can type in whatever you want. I'm just going to type in AP, stands for App Store, and close this little box that's popped up now. And every time you move it around, this little box is going to pop up, so you need to close that every time. And over here, you can see, you can change the font, right here, change the font, you can change the size, you can change the color, just here. This box here can change the color. So I'm just going to change the size, I'm going to make it a bit bigger. First, I'm going to change the color. So I'm going to make it just the red, and okay, there we go. Now I'm just going to make it a bit bigger by clicking over here. Alright, so you can click on this little arrow here that's pointing up to make it a bit bigger. Or you can just highlight it and type in whatever number you want to make it bigger. I like that. Alright, so I want this one to be my App Store. So, when you have done it and you like it, you're just going to go File. And then save as. Now the name, you can call this whatever you want, but first let's just say I'm going to call it App Store Icon, but then just stop here. So I've just called it, that's what I want to call it, App Store Icon. But now at the end of the when you finish typing, you have to put .png like that. So you'll have whatever you want to call it, right there. And then at the end you'll have .png. Then you're just going to save the folder to wherever you want. I'm just going to save it to my desktop, easy to find. And just click on save. There we go, save. And this little thing pops up. Just click on export, right here. So just click on that. And just click on save. So then it was saved, so now you can just close out of all this. And you'll see your App Store icon right there. Or whatever you've made it, right there. And if we right click on that and go to properties, type of file, it should be PNG image. So now just get out of that. Now, I want this to be my App Store icon, so I need it spelled exactly the same as the App Store icon. So I need to rename it, and I need to call it App Store. So, but it needs to be capital A, lowercase, PP, space, capital S, lowercase, TORE, and then dot PNG at the end. Press enter. So it has to be spelled exactly the same. So however it's spelled on your iPod Touch or iPhone, you need to spell there. All the capitals have to be the same. Everything has to be the same. So now when you've done that, you just create a folder on your desktop, call it whatever you want. I'm just going to call it blah. I don't know. Now just open up that. Create another folder in there called icons, but it has to be called like this. Capital I, lowercase, C-O-N-S. Alright, so I'll just zoom in there for you guys. Right there. Capital I, lowercase, C-O-N-S. When you do that, it's going to open up that, and that's where you're going to drag your picture, your icon, into there. Now you can just close out that. Now what you need to do is SSH into your iPod Touch or iPhone. If you don't know how to do that, there'll be a link in the video description over to your right, just for Windows. So I'm just going to type in my password. Now that you've SSH'd into your iPod Touch or iPhone, you need to go back once by clicking on these two dots, and then go into stash. It should be about third from the bottom or third from the top. Then just open up themes, right there. Now you're just going to minimize this, and you're going to grab your folder that you created and just drag it into the themes folder, just over here to a spare space. Drop it in there, click copy. Wait for it to go through. Now when you've done that, you need to open up Winterboard on your iPod Touch or iPhone, and you'll see whatever folder that you created, blah blah, there it is. So just tap on that, make sure it's ticked, click the home button, wait for it to respring. Now that it's resprung, just slide to unlock, and there we go. My App Store icon has changed. So that's it, guys. Please rate, comment, and subscribe. Thanks, guys. See ya.